So, recently we asked you on our Twitter which loadout we should do next, and you told us that you'd like to see a budget red loadout worth $50. Of course, how could we say no to that? We had to make some choices to actually fit in the budget, but it was fun compiling this list of skins for you. Additionally, we'll be giving away one of the skins from the video along with a knife that fits the set. Stay tuned until the end of the video to find out how to enter the giveaway. As always, if you want to buy your own loadout, head to skinwallet.com/market and use code YouTube for a 2% bonus on your first deposit. Prefer to sell skins? You can get cash 24 hours or less by selling your skins on skinwallet.com. So, let's start with the pistols. We start with a minimal wear version of the USPS Czech engine. This design is pretty clean and extremely red. What more do you need? If you prefer the P2000, our option there is a Fashion U Imperial, which slightly loses out on the redness aspect, yet still remains a nice and clean option for our loadout. On the T side, the Candy Apple is the Glock that reigns supreme. This design is really simple, but works extremely well with what we're trying to accomplish, especially in its relatively inexpensive Fashion U version. For the dualies, we decided to go with the Panther. We really didn't want to splash too much cash on a weapon that's rarely used, and even if bought, oftentimes dropped to someone who has Kevlar on a pistol round. The red accent will have to be enough. The P250 Contaminant is a brand new skin that really works both budget and color-wise. We love the texture of the skin, and its Faction U version should absolutely do this trick for us here. The 5.7 Urban Hazard is our next choice. With a cheap Faction U version, this skin really works well with our collection, without breaking the budget. For the Tech 9, we went with the Isaac. Fun fact, this skin was originally called Asimov and was a part of that collection on the workshop. Looking at it, I would love more skins with this design. It's really awesome. If you prefer the CZ, the Red Astor is what we went with. This one has a lot going for it, but it shares the minimalism of most of our skin choices. We really like how it fits in. The Desert Eagle was a tough one, mostly because Deagle skins are among the most inflated on the market. We went with the Crimson Web, which cost us a tenth of our budget. But hey, the things we do for red loadouts. If you prefer the Revolver, which, why? We're still going with a Crimson Web, albeit a much cheaper one. We move on to the heavies, where we start off with the Mag 7 Heat. It's probably the least fitting skin up to this point, and unfortunately the shotgun landscape will have a few more of those. Still, it's kind of red, so it fits, I guess. Fortunately, the Nova Candy Apple fits right in, without impacting our price too much. Not going to complain here. Next up, the sawed-off Full Stop. While the color could be better, the design is still the only shotgun that fits our inventory in our price range. We'll take it, we guess. The same goes for the Red Python, which, you know, is a thing that exists. Unfortunately, the heavy market isn't filled to the brim with awesome red skins like the pistol market is, so we're going to have to settle for skins that aren't quite perfect. The M249 System Lock is luckily a cheap skin that does fit our general vibe. Once again, clean, red accents, fits right in. Unfortunately, I can't say the same thing about the Lionfish, which kinda fits and kinda doesn't. It's a shame that a lot of these animal-based skins are not the best looking. Still, it goes in our loadout as the best skin we could find for the Ngev. We move on to the SMGs with the MAC-10 Candy Apple. This series of skins is definitely the best one for our loadout, and since we've said enough about it earlier, I'll leave it at that. For the MP9, we went with the MP9 Ruby Poison Dart, probably my favorite out of all the animal-related blobs in this loadout. The only issue I have with this one is that it could be a bit more red. For the MP7, we went with the Mischief. Once again, we were forced a bit to pick it, given a rather poor selection, but all in all, even though it lacks a cleaner aesthetic, we like this one. If you prefer the MP5 SD, Lab Rats is your best option. Strangely enough, the souvenir version is cheaper than the non-souvenir version, so hey, might as well add some gold to the rather weak red. Our selections for the UMP were even more limited, and having to stay in our budget, we decided to add the red accents of the briefing we're going to have to do. We're not really happy with the choices we had here, so if you don't use this particular gun too much, you might be inclined to skip it altogether. The Bison is our last candy apple skin. You know why, it's just red. And that absolutely works for us. For the P90, we splashed a bit of cash for one of our favorite designs in CSGO, the P90 Shallow Grave. While it doesn't really fit the aesthetic, it's the cheapest reddish P90 and also, by far, the prettiest. We move on to the rifles with the FAMAS Styx. This design is bloody and the skulls are kinda edgy, but it also has a really clean red finish we enjoy immensely. It is a little on the pricey side, but we do think it's worth it in the end. As is the Galil AR Signal, a comparatively minimalistic red skin that will work really well whenever you fall a few bucks short of an AK. For the Scout, we went with a Bloodshot, a clean skin that would be much better for our loadout if it didn't have the monster artwork, yet it still remains our best option and one we really enjoy. For the M4A4, we went with the Evil Daimyo. It's not too flashy and we definitely have better options with a bigger budget, but hey, it's red and it fits. We don't need much more than that. The case is pretty similar with the M4A1 as Blood Tiger, although its red is far less apparent than in the case of the M4. A bigger budget would definitely help out the CTs in terms of these weapons. Luckily, the Ts have another stellar skin to add to their loadout. The Orbit Mark I is the most expensive skin we have in this collection, and for good reason. Its sci-fi aesthetic blends well with our coloristic focus, making by far the best choice for our inventory within our budget. We're giving away this skin on our Twitter, so stay tuned to hear how you can enter. For the AUG, we went with the Random Access. The clean circuit board design with a slightly red tint works really well to provide a cheap skin to add to our collection. As for the SG, the Darkwing is our choice. While Game of Thrones isn't really the vibe most of our other skins have, the vibrant red color really works well with the rest of the loadout, as does the relatively low price. For the AWP, we went with the Mortis. This was hard. All the really good red AWPs were either out of our price range with the red line and the wildfire, or way out of our price range with the Prince. Luckily, the battle-scarred version of the Mortis comes to the rescue, with the wear making the skin appropriately red. It's not perfect, but it will have to do. Finally, we get to the Autosnipers. For the Scar, we had an easy choice with the Crimson Web. Couldn't really ask for a better skin for this loadout. As for the G3 SG1, battlescarred versions of the brand new Ancient Ritual just about fit our loadout, and are cheap enough to get into it. That's it for the video. However, we have one more surprise. This here Gut Knife Autotronic, which would work really well with this loadout, can be yours if you win our giveaway. To enter, follow the link in our pinned comment to our Gleam giveaway. You'll also be able to get bonus points for the giveaway for buying or selling your skins on SkinWallet Market or SkinWallet Instant. Check out the giveaway and our Twitter and Discord to find out more. Like and subscribe for more content like this, since we'll be doing at least one loadout video every week. If you want to see a specific loadout, leave a comment below or just let us know on social media. All the links are in the description. Thanks a lot for watching and have a great day.